Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Anju S. Kunjumon, and these are the major news stories of Wednesday, April 24, 2024. The Election Commission started examining complaints against PM Modi's wealth redistribution to Muslims remark. The Supreme Court reserved its verdict on the pleas seeking cross-verification of votes cast using electronic voting machines. An official from the World Food Programme said the Gaza Strip could surpass famine thresholds of food insecurity, malnutrition and mortality in 6 weeks. The U.S. Senate voted by a wide margin late Tuesday in favor of legislation that would ban TikTok in the United States if its owner fails to divest the popular short video app over the next 9 months to a year. Prohibitory orders were imposed in 4 districts of Kerala ahead of the Lok Sabha polls in the state. Let's get into the details. Amid mounting opposition pressure, the Election Commission is learned to have started examining complaints against a speech made by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Rajasthan, in which he suggested that if the Congress came to power, it would redistribute the wealth of people to Muslims. The Congress and the CPIM had separately urged the poll panel against Modi's speech on Sunday. Modi on Sunday suggested that if the Congress came to power, it would redistribute the wealth of people to Muslims and cited former PM Manmohan Singh's remark that the minority community had the first claim on the country's resources. The Congress, while urging the Election Commission to take action against Modi for his redistribution of wealth remarks made in Rajasthan, alleged they were divisive, malicious and targeted a particular religious community. The Supreme Court on Wednesday reserved its verdict on a batch of pleas seeking complete cross-verification of votes cast using EVMs with voter-verifiable paper audit trail after taking notes of answers to queries it had raised before the Election Commission. A bunch of Justices Sanjeev Khanna and Deepankar Datta sought answers from an official of the poll panel to 5 questions related to the functioning of the electronic voting machines, including whether the microcontrollers fitted in them are reprogrammable. The bench had said it needed clarification on certain aspects as there was some confusion over the answers given by the EC to frequently asked questions about EVMs. The Gaza Strip could surpass famine thresholds of food insecurity, malnutrition and mortality in 6 weeks, an official from the World Food Programme said on Wednesday. A UN-backed report published in March said that famine was imminent and likely to occur by May in northern Gaza and could spread across the enclave by July. On Tuesday, a US official said the risk of famine in Gaza, especially in the north, was very high. Meanwhile, some Palestinian civilians were fleeing their homes in northern Gaza on Wednesday, just weeks after returning because of an Israeli bombardment, which they said was as intense as those at the start of the war. After a few weeks of relative calm, Israel intensified its attacks overnight on Monday, focusing on areas, particularly in the north, from where it had previously withdrawn many of its troops, saying Hamas was no longer in control. Israel has vowed to eradicate Hamas after the militant group's fighters stormed across the border on October 7, killing 1,200 and taking 253 hostages, according to Israeli tallies. The war, now in the 7th month, has killed more than 34,000 Palestinians, with many more feared buried in the rubble. The offensive has led to waste much of the densely populated enclave, displacing most of its 2.3 million people and creating a humanitarian crisis. The U.S. Senate voted by a wide margin late Tuesday in favor of legislation that would ban TikTok in the United States if its owner, the Chinese tech firm ByteDance, fails to divest the popular short video app over the next 9 months to a year. Driven by widespread worries among U.S. lawmakers that China could access Americans' data or surveil them with the app, the bill was passed by the U.S. House of Representatives on Saturday, and U.S. President Joe Biden has said he will sign it into law on Wednesday. The four-year battle over TikTok, which is used by 170 million people in the United States, is just one front in a war over the internet and technology between Washington and Beijing. Last week, Apple said Beijing had ordered it to remove Meta platforms, WhatsApp, and Threads from its App Store in China over Chinese national security concerns. Once the bill is signed into law, ByteDance will have 270 days to divest TikTok's U.S. operations with a possible 3-month extension if there are signs a deal is progressing. With only 2 days left for the Lok Sabha election in Kerala, prohibitory orders under Section 144 of the CRPC have been invoked in Kasaragod, Thrissur and Thiruvananthapuram districts. The restrictions came into effect from 6 p.m. on Wednesday and will continue till 6 a.m. on April 27. The Pathanamthitta district collector has also imposed the curbs from 6 p.m. on April 25. Election will be held in 20 parliamentary constituencies across the state on April 26. The public campaign for the polls ended at 6 p.m. on Wednesday. As per the order issued by the collectors, gatherings of more than 5 people, rallies, public meetings, possessing lethal weapons and explosives, displaying and burning effigies, making provocatory speeches and publicly raising political slogans will be prohibited. Meanwhile, no restrictions is imposed on silent campaigns during this period. Politicians are allowed to seek votes from people at polling centers, shopping malls, shops, cinema theaters, tourist boats, wedding functions, funerals, and houses without affecting law and order. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Anju S. Kunjumon, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on Manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.